I'm Steve. Welcome to my YouTube channel. I make plastic model kits, and this review is an inbox review. This video, sorry, is a review, an inbox review of Revell's 1/72 scale ME262B1A U1 knife fighter. Very nice. A nice atmospheric shot with a 262 and some, I think that's a Halifax. It's just I don't go at. I picked this up at Model Zone. It's in the sale. £1.75. I bought it for some cheapskate. When I got it home, I thought, oh my god, because there's only markings for one 262, and the painting for the fuselage looks a bit fine to me. Anyway, so let's look what's in the box. Start off with the decals. Very small sheet, but with lots of stencils and stuff with markings for one aircraft. There's no swastikas, swizzle sticks as I like to call them, but I've got a sheet of them, so I can put those on it. And the instructions, the usual Revell, nice history of the aircraft, whether it flew or not, I don't know. According to this, it did score victories. As usual, A4 separate sheets with sprues, pictures of the sprues, and then the building instructions. All the paper lights are in Revell, but you do get the RLM numbers. Painting instruction, and I think you can see all the little squiggles on the fuselage. It's going to be a test of patience, I think. And a very fine brush, because it's not a big kit. So let's have a look what's in the box, plastic wise. First off, the canopy. This hasn't come in a separate bag, which I'm a bit disappointed with. There's no scratches on it, so I'll put it in a little bag of my own. It's quite a big canopy, and a bit look nice once it's been masked and then painted. So in the box you get four sprues, two big ones and two little ones. We'll start off with the wings. This has a finely recessed panel lines and riveting detail. There, and the other parts, gear doors, I'm sure you might have to cut them on this kit if you're having wheels down. Yeah, and you get parts for the undercarriage, engines, drop tanks. There is some flash there. Look very nice as well. Then you get the nose section with the radar aerials. They look very thick, but it's either that or a search for some etch metal, and I don't know about etch metal. There's a cockpit tub here. Instrument panel there with dowels moulding on, so you can paint them up, dry brush them. Four nose looks very nice. And then you get the fuselage with the engines and the tail plane. And this as well has fire recess lines. You can pick them up enough. And also the cockpit has some detail in it. As you can see, the sideboards mean. You get tubs, cockpit tubs with details that can be painted up. And there's the tail planes. When I'm going to build this plane, I don't know. It'd be a challenge, I think. The painted part will be anyway. So it might not be for a while. But there you go. So thanks for watching. Happy modelling.